Hi, this is a before and after video to assess the effectiveness of the performance patch that went live today. The hotfix was released to address the performance issues in the sim introduced with Sim Update 3. The patch notes are, as ever, linked in the description. Since the patch notes specifically called out Airport Kilo Delta Foxtrot Whiskey in the Dallas-Fort Worth region as being an issue, I recorded a flight taking off and flying a pseudo pattern over there. I'll refer to it as KDFW since we're not on a radio here, and I'd never flown the area before, so I had no point of reference for performance other than this flight recording. Before the KDFW recording, I also created a flight recording of a flight down the Thames in London. The flight follows the river in the more densely populated photogrammetry areas, starting around the London Eye and ending up around the University of Greenwich. I chose this area because I used to get a solid 30 FPS through this area after the UK update, but once Sim Update 3 was applied, the performance there just tanked. I made sure my community folder was clean. I also ensured that I had made my normal performance changes to the Flight Simulator EXE file itself. Then I ran up the sim and set its task priority to high. I set the dynamic thread priority boost feature of Process Lasso in the hopes of maximizing my performance. I then forced it to recreate my rolling cache. I assumed that the rolling cache would be populated by the initial flight recordings. Subsequent playbacks of the recording would then leverage that cache. During the Thames recording, I was averaging 11 frames per second with plenty of stutters. Replaying my recording, I averaged 11 frames per second with plenty of stutters until I got up to the Canary Wharf area where it increased slightly. And then it went back to 11 frames per second once I turned back to the river area. In an effort to be fair, I decided to manually cache the flight's route. Following this, I got about a 10 FPS increase overall for the flight. I was actually hitting almost 30 FPS up around the Canary Wharf area. Then I recorded and did playback tests at KDFW. I took off from 1-8 left and flew a pseudo pattern. I hit a maximum of about 40 FPS on the departure leg. The FPS dropped below 30 as I turned into the crosswind. Once on the downwind leg, I was averaging about 40 FPS again, and it maintained this through the second pass on the departure leg. For my system, this is good performance. I generally see about 30 FPS overall. Just for grins, I set a manual cache for the area just as I had done with the Thames flight. Playing the recording back, I got about a 7 to 10 FPS drop over the non-cache playback, so that makes no sense. In any event, KDFW performed just fine for me prior to caching it, so I have no idea what Asobo was talking about for that area. I kept an eye on the forums, and once I saw the patch was live, I ran up the store application, but it had no update. So I ran the sim, and it made me go back to the store where magically there was an update. Pretty small. After it was applied, I ran the sim, and it also had about a 110 megabyte patch, and that applied without incident. I then made sure the properties of the executable were correct, with full screen optimizations off and the DPI setting turned on for applications. Since I had nothing in the community folder, there was nothing to look at there, but I made a point of deleting the manual caches that I used for the pre-patch testing. That way I could do an apples-to-apples post-patch test. I repeated my flight recording playback at KDFW with no manual caching. I was seeing an average of 50 FPS at KDFW. For my system, that's pretty much unheard of. So clearly they made an effective improvement for this area. I was shocked, to be honest. There were two stutters during the flight that caused a momentary drop of about 10 FPS. But it recovered back to an average of 50 after the stutters. I reran this test with a manual cache defined for KDFW, and unlike the before test, the FPS remained the same, with the exception of not having the two stutters that I got the first time around. This time, it was perfectly smooth, so kudos to Asobo for that. Now on to the TEMS test. Again, I ran this with no manual cache and with manual cache. I'll spare you the details of the manual cache version since it had no change whatsoever to the FPS in the flight. Again, the Canary Wharf area gave me the best performance. I went from an average overall at the TEMS test from 11 to 23 without caching, so a definite improvement, but clearly not back to the 30 FPS that I had before SIM Update 3 was applied. As always, I recommend making sure your community folder is empty before you run up the SIM after the patch. That's in case there are any compatibility issues with any of your add-ins. 1.14.6.0 is the version after the patch. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope this helps some folks out there. Please hit the like if you like the videos. That really helps. And until the next video, take care.